Hello everyone, welcome to the Giving Tuesday campaign with the Chapman Cultural Center. My name is Nellie Terry, I'm the Special Events Coordinator here at the Chapman Cultural Center. Welcome to our live stream. You can donate any way today, whether it's on the post below this video, on our Facebook page, or on our website, chapmanculturalcenter.org. I'm with two gentlemen here, as you can see. They are local artists and musicians, and they participate in our downtown programming. I'm going to turn it over to Rodriguez here to introduce himself, and then Jeff.
Hi, my name is Rodriguez Cordell, the Mad Artist, and you can actually add me at the Mad Artist on Facebook, Instagram, all your social media outlets.
Hi, I'm Jeff from the Jeff Edwards Band. We are an upstate local band. We perform original music, southern rock, classic rock, and originals. You can find us at Jeff Edwards Band on Instagram or on Facebook. And you can listen to our music absolutely for free. Just do a search on Google or YouTube or Spotify. Jeff Edwards Band, Castle in the Sky is the name of the album.
So guys, today we know that you are already a fan of the arts in Spartanburg, but today you can become a supporter. And one of these things that you can support is downtown programming. Will you tell us a little bit about why you participate in downtown programming?
Okay. For those that don't know what I do, well, I go by the Mad Artist. I'm a live visual artist. I paint live with my hands. And then also I dance to music while I create. I'm also a musician as well. The reason why I participated in downtown programming is because, of course, it's the Chapman Culture Center. Any artist that is, you know, from this hometown has to circulate through here some way. This is the hub. This is the hub for you to meet other artists, your opportunity to connect with people in your community, to see exactly what you do as an artist, but then also it's just a great connector.
Yeah.
I think everyone that is trying to build something or build a brand, build anything that has to do with the arts, they have to come through this
yeah.
area, because this is where we unite.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
I participate because, I mean, certainly as a musician, you live to play, right? You've got music in your blood, you hear it in your head, you're writing music, you want to get out there and play it. You can play for yourself, by yourself, as much as you want, but there's such a connection when you get out there and give it back to the people. And I think the nice thing about the street music is it gives you a chance to say, let's distill this music you perform as a band down to its purest form, where it's just you and a guitar and your voice and maybe a handful of people, maybe a small crowd, maybe just one or two. As long as they're listening, you're giving them your energy and they're kind of reflecting that back to you. And it's such a cool connection to have that. And I mean, let's face it, is there any bad reason to go downtown? It's like so cool and so many places to visit, and it's just so alive and vibrant that you know, I'd rather be strumming my guitar down there and then just sitting by myself at home, especially more so because people are appreciating it.
For sure. Right.
And I think it's about the exposure as well.
Yeah.
Because people don't know that you exist unless you have to plop them right in front of to say, hey, I'm here and I have a voice. And I think that's what downtown programming allows the artist to do. It allows you to reach those people.
So guys, we are definitely creating a vibe in our cultural district in the downtown area with the musicians that you see here beside me for downtown programming. I think I'd like to ask you, what are some of the responses that you get from people that are passing by or maybe looking back to see you? I know the Mad Artist wears headphones a lot of his time, so he has a crowd and doesn't really know it. But speak a little bit to one of the reactions about the community feeling that people are experiencing while they're downtown in the cultural district.
I think it's always a cool feeling because I have this this helmet on while I'm performing, and normally I try to tune pretty much everything out. And the only reason I do that is because I have to be focused on my craft. It allows me to go into my zone where I'm able to say, okay, it's not about a performance for me, it's about me being true to myself as an artist. So what when I am in the zone and I am creating, I get lost in that. And so sometimes when I'm performing, I'll turn around and there's a huge crowd behind me. And I never, I'm like, oh, where'd you guys come from? Like, this is cool.
Yeah.
And so it always surprises me how it draws people in.
Yeah.
Especially even if I'm not even playing my music out loud for people to hear. The fact that they even see something different going on downtown, I think it raises their eyebrows.
Yeah.
And that exposure in our community is important, only because, for one, we don't have a lot of, you know, performers downtown just, you know, busking. Like, in Greenville, they set it up constantly, and there's tons of artists. Asheville, the same way, and I think Chapman Culture Center is trying to get people to start moving in that direction to see, hey, this is not out of the norm. Like, you know, artists, you know, they set up out in public and they expose that to the community. I think it enriches the art community.
For sure.
Because they see the culture, they see the musicians doing something. And we're trying to do something about it by exposing them to real art.
The responses are always, a lot of them are really positive and such confidence building experiences, you know, like, and it comes in many forms. You know, you'll get someone who'll walk up, listen for 15 seconds, and just tell you it was fantastic, leave you a tip, and that's all they needed was that 15 seconds. Or you'll get people that are hanging out, kind of having a beer, sitting with their friends, and they never leave, they're happy. They are enjoying the soundtrack. It's not something they can hear anywhere else. It's live. They're digging the energy, so they keep, you know, buying drinks or buying food from the local business, and they just sit there and kind of embrace it. That's pretty cool. You know, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say, but it's also kind of interesting when people just walk straight on by and you don't think they're listening because they're busy. You know, they got bags they're carrying, or they got kids they're hustling down the street, and you think, well, you know, your first instinct is, hey, they don't care. But, you know, you see them a few blocks later, and, you know, they were listening, they enjoyed it, they just, you know, they had other things they had to get done, but you contributed to that small space of their life. You know, you gave them some energy while they walked by, and they probably gave you a little energy back, whether you realized it or not. It's just, kind of like being the live soundtrack for a city.
For sure.
You know?
Yeah.
For sure. So I know that I'm guilty of this, but I do not carry cash on me. So when I see you guys in the cultural district, I may not be able to tip them. But today you can donate, and the money that you donate will go right back into the programs that employ these people down on the streets of the downtown cultural district. We are embarking on our program next year, and the money will go into the pockets of our local artists beside me, two of them right here. I think my last question for both of you will be, how has this impacted your career as an artist or as a musician as well?
I think it has impacted me in a way where, you know, step into social media world for a moment.
Yeah.
Only because that's cool. Like, I love the followers that I get from all around the world. It's awesome. But when you actually are here in your hometown and people have the opportunity to actually meet you and know you personally and buy art from you, they know your story that goes along with that. I think that goes a lot further.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you a genuine connection. And that's something that I really appreciate, because now people in my hometown recognize that I am here, and they give me a follow, but it's also local, and I know that they're like, they could be my next door neighbors.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that sense of community is very, very important.
Yeah.
Because knowing who's here is, it pushes your brand so much further, because not just yourself pushing your brand, but people in the community seeing the brand and pushing it too, because they advocate for you.
Yeah.
That word of mouth is so much more important.
Mm-hmm.
It goes further than any amount of money can, because people believe in something, they believe in a brand, and they'll help push it. And I think that takes you so much further as your exposure, as you grow in the community. That love is genuine.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think that's something that we have to continue to hold on to, because if we get into this world of everything is social media,
distant,
and those no genuine connections. And I think when you were talking about how people can, you know, walk into, you know, hearing you play or seeing you create, you never know how that impacted their life that day.
Sure.
And I think it means something more where you're in downtown and that culture, you're buying local, you're seeing local, and I think that gives the local cap like a bigger, it gives us a bigger platform.
For sure, for sure.
Well, one thing I like about that is, you know, when you're in the studio and you're tracking everything the same way and building all those textures for a recording, it's a really awesome piece of art. But then when you take it out to the street and you sing it to people and you perform it, you kind of, you get some energy from them.
Oh, and yeah, it's
new and unique. It's kind of like you discover it new for yourself that time, and you give them something they can't get from a recording or from TV, you know. You're there in person, it's changing slightly, it's not delivered the same way. Maybe you discover a cool new inflection, you know, or some new notes, or maybe change a section slightly, you know, just for that performance that you kind of stick in the back of your brain and say, I'm gonna use that next time I play that album. I know one of the things I really appreciate about the program is being able to mingle with people and let all the flavors kind of come together like a really awesome stew pot, you know?
Yeah.
It's a little different every time it gets made. I've always really appreciated that about playing Sundays Unplugged here in the middle of the art and the people who come by. And I'm a huge fan of the arts anyways, you know, not just music. It's just, it's always kind of been in my spirit to want to make things. So I like collaborating with people. I like arts. You know, we played Artisphere this year, and I just love that giant music festival with a bunch of live performance art too. And I think it's awesome that Chapman is creating that right here in our community in Spartanburg.
For sure, for sure. Well, I know that y'all, you know, our downtown programming season is over for this year, but y'all have a lot of other opportunities going on. So where can people find you? Are y'all on social media?
Well, I'm an artist at West Main Artist Co-op, and so all of my art is there. That's my hub, and so you can always come through there and shop. And I'm also on social media at The Mad Artist. You spell mad with three D's. And also you can find me on themadartist.com. Just Google The Mad Artist. just make sure you spell it with three D's. And someone here knows how to get in contact with me. So if you're looking for booking or anything, you can go on my site and you can book me as well for live performances.
Yeah, Jeff.
Probably the best place to figure out where we're playing next or what we're doing is jeffedwardsband.com. If you forget that, just remember Jeff Edwards Band, and that will tie into the search engines and get you where you want to go. Number one thing you can do to help us out, follow us on Facebook and listen to the albums on the streaming outlet of your choice. I prefer Spotify, but you can YouTube us, Amazon Music, so on and so forth. Listen to the music and send us a comment. Let us know what you think, if you love it, if you hate it.
Yeah.
If you hate it but you can't get it out of your head, you know, send me a message and we'll talk about it, and maybe you'll help influence the next album we're recording, you know. We're always playing out and about. We play in Spartanburg, all over the upstate, Western North Carolina, Northern Georgia. So check the website. There'll be a show near you, and we definitely plan to keep stripping things down and doing the street music next season when it warms up. And Sundays Unplugged has always been one of my favorite gigs because it's 100% original, so you can come out on a boring Sunday afternoon and sit with me and let me make it more exciting for you for a couple of hours and hear a bunch of secret stories about where the songs really came from.
Awesome.
That's awesome.
Those those are secrets you won't get from the website or online. You gotta sit right here and maybe I'll tell you if it was about someone or it wasn't.
Awesome. So just referencing Sundays Unplugged, and that is another program that the Chapman Cultural Center does here every Sunday from 2 to 4, another program that you can support. If you are interested in more information from either of these artists, we are tagging both of them, so make sure to follow the links to both of their social pages. I'd like to thank everybody, and especially these two artists here in the Spartanburg area for joining us today. Again, you can give today for our Giving Tuesday campaign. It's on our website at chapmanculturalcenter.org. It's also on our Facebook page and the button below. And remember that our board of the Chapman Cultural Center is matching up to $2,000 today, so you will double any purchase, or excuse me, any donation that you give. So that's an added bonus right there. Thank you both for being here, and thank you all for keeping the arts alive in the Cultural District in Spartanburg.
Thank you.